Hello, Paula. Thank you for joining me today and agreeing to the interview. Your field's hypnosis. Can you just explain why you chose hypnosis and your journey into that area?
Yes, I used to be a biology teacher and was so for 35 years, and I developed a shoulder injury that was extremely painful, which I did decorating because we have very high ceilings here, and went along to the doctor and they did all sorts of things, x-rayed it, gave me cortisone injections, and nothing seemed to alleviate the pain. And somebody told me about self-hypnosis, and I went on a self-hypnosis training workshop and found that I could indeed heal myself, and I did. And I've got full mobility back now in my shoulder, and I was so amazed by this, in awe of it, that I went on to study hypnotherapy in full, not thinking I'd change career because I love teaching. But the more I learnt, the more fascinated I became. And I set up my own business in 2000, and by 2004, it was just too much to be doing both jobs, and I had to make quite a traumatic decision and left teaching, and here I am.
Excellent. Some people, when we talk about hypnosis, are very scared and nervous of hypnosis. Do you want to explain a little bit about what hypnosis is and how it works?
Well, hypnosis is simply a deep state of relaxation, creating an altered sense of awareness. And in fact, we all go into hypnosis about 90% of the day. Sorry, not 90, 60% of the day. So it's a daydreaming state. In fact, children are in hypnosis about 90% of the day up until they're about four. So it's something we all do naturally. And therefore, what I do in therapeutic hypnosis is using what we do naturally, but with effect. Because when you're in this daydreaming state, you're at your alpha theta brainwave pattern, one can access the unconscious mind where there's a huge resource of information so that one can help oneself in healing, changing behavior patterns that you don't want. What I do, therapeutic hypnosis, is of course very, very different from stage hypnosis. Stage hypnosis, it is a show, and so the stage hypnotist will choose people who are going to cooperate with them and also who go into this state very, very easily. There's about 5% of the population that can drop into this state very, very quickly. So they select those people. And of course, when they're doing a show, it looks as if they're taking over that person and making them do whatever they want. But that isn't actually the case, because a hypnotist cannot make you do anything that you don't wish to do. Your conscious mind would kick in.
It is that cooperation, isn't it? And even the unconscious, if it feels unsafe, will kick you out of it.
That's right, yes.
A good example is when you're driving and you don't, you know, you're on automatic pilot. And then
that's right.
Happens, you're just pulled out of it. So.
That's right, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, you go into the hypnotic state whenever you're doing anything that you enjoy. So watching television is another good example. Reading a good book, you get totally engrossed in it. And you're just going to those alpha theta brainwave patterns.
And for you, what do you specialise in particularly? Is there any further niching of your hypnosis?
Yes, well, I suppose the majority of the work I do is hypnobirthing, which is the use of hypnosis to have a natural birth and as pain-free as possible. I can't guarantee that it'll be totally pain-free because everybody's pain threshold is different, but it can certainly make a huge difference to the experience, so it becomes an enjoyable experience as it should be. And I also work a great deal with people with illness, anxiety, cancer, IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, depression, and all anxiety related things.
And what type of results do you get? I mean, do you get a lot of feedback? Have you had any cases or examples you can share where you've made a huge difference?
Yes, I get quite a lot of feedback. There was a similar case to me where the medical profession had written me off because of my age. I was over 50 when I did my shoulder injury. And I treated this woman who had these quite curious sores all over her legs. And she came to me and said, what I really want to do is to be able to wear a skirt again. But the medical profession have written me off. They don't know what the cause is or why it's happening. And I just did some work with her and got her to release anything that she no longer wanted. And 3 weeks later, she came back to me and was wearing a skirt. It was quite amazing, actually. So she was thrilled and I was thrilled. So the power of the mind is amazing. I think you can do so much to heal yourself, to cure unwanted illnesses, to a very large degree. And that's why it's so useful as well for giving birth. And so I get a lot of feedback from mums that have had quite difficult births the first time round and then used my techniques and had a much more pleasant experience.
Can you explain a little bit more about that? I mean, I know that my delivery with my son was not the most pleasant experience of my life.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
2 hours and,
Yes. Well, it often is. I think we tend to lose sight of the fact that the female body is actually designed to give birth. And I think all women should know a bit more about how their body actually functions. I am a biology teacher, and that's why I sort of use my biology and the hypnotherapy techniques that I use to devise my inner power hypnobirthing scheme. The uterus is a muscle that is not under the control of the will. And so when it's time for the birth, it's going to contract whether you want it to or not. And basically, a mum has two choices, either to work with her body or against it. If she chooses the latter, to work against it, then all her skeletal muscles will tense up. And so she's actually working against what her body really wants her to do. If you work with your intuition, trust how your body's going to work, then the baby tends to flow out much more easily. So that's what I do, is teach relaxation techniques so that the body responds by producing endorphins, serotonins, the happy hormone, as I call it, that is the body's natural pain control. They're morphine-based drugs. Hormones, not drugs, they're morphine-based hormones. And so the body can stay in a calm state.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
therefore the process is easier.
He was the wrong way round. So.
Ah, right.
And they didn't
yes.
find out until 22 hours in. So.
Right.
But, yeah.
Well, hypnosis can be used when we know that the babies are the wrong way round. It can be used for actually turning the baby. It can be used for moving the placenta if it's not in the best of places. It's amazing actually what hypnosis can do and help you achieve.
Excellent. You've actually written a book. Do you want to tell us a little bit more about actually your journey in producing the book? Because I know it was one of your big goals. So just explain.
Yes. Yes. I wanted to produce a complete package for hypnobirthing, which was a book with all the explanation, but also with a self-hypnosis CD, because that is very, very useful. And I, in fact, make CDs for all my clients. So that's what the book is. It's about hypnobirthing, and it's called Birth Made Easy, because I think if you learn these skills, then birth is easier than you think it's going to be. Unfortunately, today, there's so much information out there on the internet, all these magazines, and also from the medical profession. And we have lost sight that the female body is designed to give birth. It's all in a medical situation now. And I think if we can be as natural as possible and learn how to work with our bodies, then birth is a much more pleasurable experience. So that's what my book is about. And it takes the mum through the pregnancy, through the birth, through bonding with her baby, breastfeeding if she chooses to do that, healing up afterwards, and also getting your figure back after the birth.
I'd like to ask about breastfeeding, because that's an interesting one for me, because there's a lot of people seem to struggle with it.
Yes.
And how does that work in terms of hypnosis? Does that really help?
Yes, because it helps you to be more confident in your ability to breastfeed, because not all babies know how to do it either. We assume that they instinctively know what to do, but they don't, and sometimes they have to be taught how to latch on as well. So it's about getting yourself and your baby in the correct position, and also getting the nipple in the correct position. And it's not the baby just taking the end of the nipple, it has to take all of it and the areola tissue, and then that releases the milk. But even if there is a bit of a struggle, after 6 weeks it's usually resolved itself. It depends also on the tissue of the mother and how sensitive she is to the sucking of the baby. But again, I give...
How do you help with that?
Yes.
My memory of it was very painful in the end.
Yes. Did you manage it in the end?
Yeah, I breastfed for 13 weeks and then I had to go back to work, so I gave up after that.
But oh, well, well
by
done.
By that time, I was so sore.
Yes. Well, there are various techniques to help with that, and they're included in the book as well. There are some natural remedies that you can do also. Hmm. Yes.
Oh, very interesting. And I know it was your goal. When did it become your dream to write the book?
Well, it became my dream after a lot of my mums actually said to me that I ought to get this technique written down. So it was a lot of encouragement from them. And I did some research, and I hadn't seen any books for pregnancy and birth with a CD attached. They were all sort of separate downloads at the time. So that was what I wanted to do. And so it was quite a journey to find a publisher that would do that for me with a CD in the back. And I did. So very good, the Hot Hive.
And it's released when?
The book is now out. I've heard today that some people that pre-ordered it have already got their copies, so it's actually out now, and it's on my my website, the publisher's website, and on Amazon and Waterstones and Smith's websites. And actually today it went into Waterstones in Croydon on the shelves.
Oh, brilliant.
So that's very exciting, ready for my book launch.
Which is when?
That is on Saturday, this Saturday the 29th of October,
from
11 to 12. Yes, Waterstones Croydon Wick Gift Centre.
Excellent.
Yes.
Thank you for being with me today. It's been really, really insightful, and especially a niche that, you know, not many people cover. I think it's just really very valuable, and one I wish I'd known about all those years ago.
Well, thank you. Thank you for asking me.
Thank you. Take care. Bye.
And you. Bye now.